congratulations is definitely in order. I have reached a full year of being employed at one job. Now, to know me is to love me, and to love me is to understand. A full year at a job, at one job, that's good. So I'm trying to clap, but I'm holding my phone up, so this is me clapping for myself. I have my own audience, my own little audience. So yeah, let's get into the intro. Remember them challenges when they do this and you come back all beat and fabulous? No need. I get all that myself, and I feel like that is a very important thing when a woman is independent.
My mouth's a moist and the liquid is just going everywhere.
That's trigger points. Everybody has trigger points. Let's just be honest. Those are my trigger points.
Yoplait yogurt is like, I hit every single option possible. Even though that's just a label, we're trans women, but we're still human at the end of the day. We want what everybody else wants, and that's just to be loved and accepted. That's all we damn want. Love and acceptance.
This is what we're going to do, because I feel that I'm getting out of my character. So, this is what we're going to do.
It's
got to
be alive, isn't it?
Mine, we came a long way.
Hey guys, come on in. Before we even start, y'all be sure. Is my wig crooked, honey? Should I pull it back? Oh, okay. Y'all be sure to like, share, and subscribe. It's free to subscribe. I know I am infamous for saying that a video is not going to be long, and the bitch still be long. This one won't be long, I promise you. Let me address the noise in the background. That is my AC. I have a window unit, but hey, I don't care because it blows out cool, calming air. And I love cool, calming air. Okay? Good old air conditioning. I was profiled tonight. Profiled. Me and a coworker of mine who I can say friend to, because you know, coworkers and friends, that's two different fields, so we need to keep those lines very solid. But you know, she has grown into becoming someone I can say a friend. So we went out to eat after work, and one of my favorite restaurants, y'all, is Outback Steakhouse. We went there, and let me tell you about my rate. I'm very observant. I pay attention to all my surroundings. I'm a black trans woman in America, in the South of America. I have to pay attention to my surroundings. So when we got there, I'm like, yeah, two booth would be best, perfect, actually. So we get the booth. I see the section we in. The server who's in that section was a black guy. And he gave us a look. He made a certain look, like as if he was real aggravated. His energy was off. And, you know, we are all entitled to have bad days. But it's 7 days out the week. Every day can't be a bad day, because if my memory is correct, we had him, I was with another person, we had him in that same section, actually, we had him, and he was the same way. He was just very standoffish. And you have to understand, to be a server, because I am a server, to be a server, you have to have charisma. You have to have a personality for it. You're working for your tips. So your guest should be number one priority. I say all that to say, he treated us poorly. He didn't come check on us. If we needed anything, we had to flag him down. But he was giving his attention to the 8-top, who was right next to us. 8-top of Vanellope. I think I'd wipe my damn brows off. This morning it was right here. I don't wipe my damn brows off. But anyway, he kept going to the eight top of the vanilla people. And he ignored me and my guest, my person, who I was with. So I was like, okay. Okay. So that was a little... And from a server point of view, because I am a server. You know, I just like bring it. I'm just going to be telling everybody I am a server. I find myself judging other servers. Like when I go out to eat at other restaurants, I find myself judging their performances and comparing how they greet the table versus how I greet the table. I don't know if that's a good or bad thing, but I find myself doing that when I go out to eat with people or by myself. But as a server, I can understand why he would feel a certain type of way seeing a black person sit at his table, even if that black person is me. But the bigger picture, grand scheme of things, he should have just treated us the way he treated the other table, because his tip would have been a lot bigger. Now, my suggested tip to him was supposed to have been $5, because I only got some wings, I got the Blumenburger, and a water. And I think I got a margarita. Yeah, I got a margarita. That took forever to get to the table. Service was just horrible. My suggested tip to him was $5, but I left him $9.45, because although he was a horrible server, I understand he's still living off his tips, as most servers. So, you know, I gave him the $9. And I didn't feel upset about it. I felt disappointed, because it could have been more than $9. And that's what I was tipping him, with him having horrible service. Had he had good service, he would have got a lot more than $9, because I was prepared to give him a high 20. But when I realized it was him from last time, I didn't expect too much, because last time he was bad like that too. And it goes to show, you're not supposed to judge a book by its cover. You're really not. And I need to say that to myself and mean it. But, you know, a lot of times them books, we need to judge them, because they be just like the books that we thought they was going to be. Okay? Yeah, so he missed out on a good blessing. So I'm sorry to this man. He definitely missed the blessing. I want to tell y'all something funny, though, before I go. A year yesterday made my anniversary for this restaurant job. Ironically, Outback was my first choice, because I had an interview before I had an interview at my current job. It was at Outback. And I blew the interview out the water. And the manager was, I had him laughing, you know, I'm Maya, so I got the personality. Needless to say, they never called me. And they missed out, because tonight I sparked a great conversation by simply just being me, wearing my motherfucking work uniform, and it sparked a great conversation with the waitresses and the other waitresses, not our waiter, because he was too busy kissing other people's asses and not ours. And just sparked the conversation with them, and they complimented my personality. Like, are you a server? Yeah, I bet you know, I can tell you're a server by your personality and all that kind of stuff. And it just, I say all that to say, I could have been a server at Outback, but you bitches didn't choose me, so someone else chose me. So now y'all gotta watch me shine from the audience.